Hello students, welcome to AC Engineering. This video we are going to see the series resistance and parallel resistance, how they are connected in a circuit and how to solve the problem. The relevant introduction, Ohm's law, Kirchhoff's law and the series parallel resistors, equivalent resistance, how to find the same, and all the things are already completed and posted in YouTube. Anybody doesn't refer the same, you please refer and come back to this video, then only it could be understandable. All the links were given in the description box. You please be find the links, complete the previous video, then come back to this video. We'll see the first problem. Find the equivalent resistance of the circuit given here. Observe the circuit. Let point A is a starting point. 2 ohm resistor is connected here and then it is a junction point. From this junction, 3 resistors are connected in parallel via 3 ohm, 6 ohm and 9 ohm, and all the resistors are connected in the next end as a junction point. Then it is connected via 4 ohm resistor to D. So totally we have an 4 points, name it as B and C. How to solve the problem? What is required? We need to find the equivalent resistance. Here a series combination and parallel combinations are there. First try to solve the parallel combination. How to find the parallel combination? Because the current differs, that's why 3 resistors are connected in parallel. How to find the parallel resistance? Means 3 ohm, 6 ohm and 9 ohm are connected in parallel. In order to find the equivalent resistance of the parallel connected 3 resistors, R equivalent or 1 by R equivalent equal to 1 by 3 plus 1 by 6 plus 1 by 9, which has a takes up the value of 11 by 18, which is equal to 1 by 64 ohm. And here the value is 1.64 ohm. Now what should be the reduced structure? Reduced structure is point A. Now point B and C is reduced as 1.64. Here 2 ohm resistor, here 1.6 ohm, here 4 ohm, and last point is D. So the equivalent resistances, series combinations of these 3 resistors, 2, 1.64 and 4, the cumulative summation is 7.64. So in this way, this is a very simple problem for us to solve. Now coming back to the next problem. A battery of 12 volt is connected across the terminals A, B of the circuit given below. Okay, we'll observe the circuit later on. Continue the problem. Find the current flowing in each resistance. So we need to find current flowing through each resistance. Observe the circuit. A is a starting point, then via A here a junction point where 3 resistors, 4 ohm, 5 ohm and 6 ohms are connected in parallel, and other end of these 3 resistors are connected in one junction point. Then next again it has a junction point where 8 ohm and 12 ohm resistors are connected, and in the other end we have a junction point. Then it connected to the point B. So A and B is the points given in a problem. In a junction point, we have to name it as C, D, E and F. So how to solve the problem? First, try to find the equivalent circuit of this parallel connected resistor, then equivalent resistance of this parallel connected resistor. How to find the equivalent circuit in between R? Resistance in between RCD, 1 by RCD equal to 1 by 4, 1 by 5, 1 by 6, which takes up the value 1.6216. The equivalent resistance in between E and F means R equivalent in between E and F means we know the 2 resistors are connected in parallel formula R1 R2 by R1 plus R2. which is equal to 8 into 12 by 8 plus 12, 4.8 ohm. Now what is the equivalent circuit? Now this is compressed as a single, we'll see here, compressed as a single 1.62 ohm and here one more 14.8 ohm. Both resistors are series, that's why summing up the same we will get an R equivalent circuit. R equivalent for the whole circuit. Now what is the question asked? Find the current through flowing in the each resistance. What is the current in each resistor? So while solving in current through each resistor, what we can observe? See here, all the resistors 4, 5 and 6 ohm resistors are in parallel, so current differs. Here also 8, 12 current differs. Then how to solve the problem? So that first try to find the total current. According to Ohm's law, total current I is equal to voltage applied divided by the total equivalent circuit of this equivalent circuit. It means resistance in the equivalent circuit. 12 divided by 6.4216, that is 1.8687 amps. You have to make it as a calculator calculation. So that we found an current through the circuit in the very starting point here. Current through the circuit is found 1.68 something. Then try to find current through each resistor. First, voltage between C and D. How to find voltage between C and D? So according to Ohm's law, V into V equal to I into R. Current is the same current, 1.6 into, sorry, total current 1.8 into the resistance between CD. One resistance in between CD is 1.6. So mere multiplication, we got the answer for voltage between CD. Similarly, try to find voltage between EF. Voltage between EF is total current into its equivalent resistance, so 8.9. Now find the current through 4 ohm resistor is voltage. Here is voltage divided by particular resistor, V by, sorry, R. So resistor R value is 4, then voltage 3.030. So current through 4 ohm resistor is voltage divided by that particular resistor. Why? Because 5, 4 and 6 ohm resistors are, see here, this 4, 5 and the 6 ohm resistors are connected in parallel. So all receives same voltage. If we found the voltage, then it is easier for us to make a current, because V by R relationship in a, according to Ohm's law. Now the current through 4 ohm resistor is 3.0303 divided by 5, so we found a current in amps. Similarly, current through 6 ohm resistor is the total voltage, means the current through the 6 ohm resistor is voltage across CD divided by the particular resistor 6. Similar cases applicable here in an 8 ohm and a 12 ohm resistor. Why? Because is, again coming back to the circuit, see here, in a circuit 8 ohm and a 12 ohm are connected in parallel. So if we found the voltage in between E and F, we try to find a current easily by the ratio V by R. So voltage, if it is known, it is common for both the resistors, and a resistor is the particular value. So we already found a voltage value of a branch EF, voltage across EF is 8.9698. So current through 8 ohm resistor, that voltage 8.9698 divided by 8 takes up the value 1.1212. Then current through 12 ohm resistor is 8.9698 divided by 12, it's 0.7475. In this way, we can easily find the series and then parallel resistance combination, how the current flow occurs. We can easily adapt. These are all the very simple problem. It is, if you can understand the conceptual things behind the solution part, it is very, very, very much useful for us to make a bigger part B aspect of a question solution. Hope students, you can understand the concept. We'll see rest of the parts in the next video. Thank you. Thanks for your support.